Since the beginning of 2021, inflation has been rising, both in advanced economies and emerging markets. But is inflation here to stay? And just how worried should we be? My name is Francesca Caselli, and I'm an economist studying inflation. After months of lockdowns, people are now eager to go out and spend. At the same time, supply chain disruptions have been contributing to input shortages, and food prices have been on the rise. All this is happening amid still substantial policy support as economies recover from the deep contraction of 2020. However, there is still a lot of uncertainty related to the pace of the recovery. At the beginning of the pandemic, we observed large price movements in some areas of the economy. In the first few months of 2020, no one wanted to get on a plane, and the price of airline tickets dropped. Likewise, the price of hospitality services plummeted. On the other hand, the price of face masks, well, we all know that story. Prices in different sectors, in fact, were going in different directions. At first, we thought that these price movements were really extreme, but then we took a closer look. If we compare price dispersion across sectors, comparing, for instance, the price of food to the price of housing, and we also compare it to the past, we were surprised to find that actually the price dispersion we observe today isn't so dramatic. The reason mostly is that the housing and food sectors didn't move as much as they had during the 2008 global financial crisis. Another key concept that policymakers monitor closely to understand inflation outlook is people's perception of inflation or inflation expectations. In fact, one of the hallmarks of stable monetary policy is the ability to anchor inflation expectations. For example, when you go out to buy some gasoline for your car, is what you are paying roughly in line with what you expected to pay? If your expectations at the fuel pump are stable over time, then they're anchored. This matters because a significant gap between expectations and reality can have an inflationary effect. For example, if you read in the news that there's a spike in the price of cars and you expected it to remain high next year, you might be more likely to buy cars now before the cost goes up even more. This higher demand for cars might push prices even higher, making inflation expectations self-fulfilling. Therefore, understanding expectation is crucial to understanding how inflation will evolve. Given all the turbulence and disruption of the pandemic, we wanted to know whether inflation expectations remained anchored, or whether the shock was so big that expectations had become de-anchored. We found no evidence that either the pandemic or the unprecedented policy responses have de-anchored expectations. And this is a very welcome development. We see a temporary increase in headline inflation both for advanced economies and emerging markets, meaning that inflation will return to pre-pandemic levels starting by mid-2022. However, given the recovery's uncharted nature, considerable uncertainty remains, particularly related to the assessment of economic slack. Risks are tilted to the upside for both advanced economies and emerging markets. This means that there's slightly higher probability that inflation will be higher than our own baseline forecast. But what did policymakers do to bring inflation and inflation expectations under control in the past? Past episodes of inflation acceleration show that when expectations become the anchor, inflation can quickly take off and be costly to rein back in. Policymakers who managed to avoid inflation expectations to become unhinged in the past were ready to act more quickly. So when they saw inflation expectations de-anchoring, they were prepared to intervene with strong policy actions. And a part of that success is due to the role of clear and credible communication to announce and explain the policy measures as they were being enacted. So, just how worried should we be about this inflation scare? Looking ahead, inflation is expected to be back to pre-pandemic levels by mid-2022, but with risks tilted to the upside given the uncharted nature of the economic recovery. Clear communication combined with appropriate monetary and fiscal policies is key to prevent inflation expectations to de-anchor and lead to a self-fulfilling inflationary spiral.